Hello, I am Representative Dan Griffey. I'm a lifetime resident of Mason County, husband, father, grandfather, firefighter, and legislator. I have continued to take actions and get results, protecting our elderly and ending the statute of limitations on felony sex crimes. I have continued to take a stand for those who are vulnerable and need assistance. It is not just my job, it's who I am. It has been an honor to have your support, and I am asking for your vote to continue the work we started. We are stronger together. I am Dan Griffey, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Griffey for State House 35th District Republican.
Logs are moving with breakneck speed through the sawmill and planer lines at Sierra Pacific Industries' stud mill in Shelton. Construction on the state-of-the-art mill started about 2 years ago, not long after SPI bought the former mill site from Simpson Logging Co. when it closed in 2015. Today, the new mill produces 2x4, 2x6, and 2x8 boards. SPI spokeswoman Lisa Perry says the mill is the fourth or fifth largest lumber producer in the United States and the number one producing sawmill in Washington State.
We're still not up to full capacity, but we're almost fully staffed now. We're up to 267 employees we hit yesterday. So that's exciting, although we still have lots of job openings with lots of career potential. So that's a message we're trying to get out to.
Perry took Shelton-area media representatives on their first tour Friday. The sawmill was dedicated on Monday.
Basically, the logs are brought in from about a 100-mile radius, and they're brought in, and they're trucked in. They are loaded into a log yard. They're put through a debarker that you'll be able to see, and then they're sent down a line to be cut to length. Then they're staged to go through the rest of the sawmill functions. That's gang saws, edgers, profilers, and they're optimized by computers and high-tech stuff at every single level to get the most out of the fiber. Then they're sent out to the kilns to be dried, and then they come back in and they're planed and trimmed to final size, graded, stacked, and then shipped out all over the United States.
The 175-square-foot building houses two full sawmill and planer lines. The mill has been up and running for about a year after a series of tests.
So the wood for this mill comes from all over the Olympic Peninsula, a little bit south, all the way over to, like, I'd say Eatonville, the Muckleshoot Reservation. That's kind of as far as we go east. We don't go as far south because we have two mills that direction.
Perry says the byproduct of the mill, chips and sawdust, goes into other products.
If you went back 40 or 50 years, you probably wasted 30 to 50% of the fiber that was part of the tree. Now we use basically every flake of fiber for something. So it starts with chips are sent off to paper and cardboard manufacturers. Shavings here locally are sent to Gem Shavings up at the old Mill 5 location to make livestock bedding. Sawdust is sold for pellet manufacturers, and then last but not least, we of course use some of the sawdust and fuel to power the boiler to create steam for a dry kiln.
One of the more difficult duties at SPI has been recruiting employees.
It has been hard to recruit. With the economy better, I think people have options, and so we need to make sure people understand the great career opportunities we have here.
Perry says the mill now employs 267 people and is looking for 10 to 15 more to add to its staff.
The trades kind of lost some of their luster back in the day, and so I think a lot of us in the education field are working to make sure people understand what great job opportunities are in the trades right now.
I'm Jeff Chu for iFiber One News.